Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm reviewing When Dimple Met Rishi, and I'm specifically going to talk about what I liked about this book and what I didn't like about this book. And believe me, I have a lot of opinions on this book. Let me start off by saying that I actually enjoy Sandhya Menon's books, and just because I was not a fan of this book, that does not mean I'm not gonna check out her other books. I really liked From Twinkle with Love and There's Something About Sweetie, but this book was just not for me. So the synopsis of this book is about two people, Dimple Shah and Rishi Patel, and they are they go off to college, but the idea is that they both haven't met each other before and they have been put into some sort of an arranged marriage kind of a situation, and it's all about how they meet and how they eventually realize that they have fallen in love. So this felt like a very breezy, fun romance kind of a read, and I was really excited to read this book. It was okay for a little part, but then everything started going really downhill for me, and I'm gonna break down exactly what the problems were. First of all, there's Dimple. So I started off actually liking Dimple's character. She seemed like she knew what she wanted, and she was like a no-nonsense kind of a girl, and so I thought that I could actually relate to her. She's pretty nice actually. But in just a couple of pages, I realized I was totally wrong. She seemed so self-obsessed and insecure, and she just started making perceptions about people and judgments on them so darn quickly, and then she ended up whining all the time, and I really did not enjoy that side of her. She kept the first 40 pages of the book or so, she kept talking about how she did not wear makeup, how she was not like any other girl, and I just felt like every time she kept talking like this, she just like started putting other girls down. So everyone is to themselves. There isn't a particular way that someone's supposed to be, right? So if she doesn't wear makeup, or if she doesn't do certain things certain ways, or if she is into coding, or which she is in this book, that doesn't necessarily mean that a different girl who's not is not normal or is normal. And I just did not like the fact that she kept putting down people who were different from her, but kept thinking that she's the one who's been put down all the time, and that really put me off. Then she starts talking about rich people in a way that I don't know, she actually goes and corrects someone else's name, and I don't think anybody has the audacity to do that. Everyone pronounces their name the way they do, and she goes and pinpoints to this guy and like tells him that's not how you pronounce your name. But then she starts behaving like she's the damsel in distress here, and Rishi ends up saving her. So I don't know, she was just really judgmental. She starts naming the cool kids, and she starts like, she's really hypocritic, and she was just not my type. And then I think that, okay, so I was not a fan of Dimple, maybe I will like Rishi and I can still manage this book. But no, Rishi is 18 and all he talks about is getting married. He is an MIT Stanford 2B graduate, and he has a lot of different things that he does, and he's rich and blah blah blah, but then nothing matters to him, because the moment he's been told that this is a girl he's gonna get married to, that's it. That's all he thinks about. In fact, the first time he met her, he just came and told her that he's gonna get married to her. Now, look, I'm Indian and I get arranged marriages and I get how it works here, but this was totally creepy, and there's no way that I think it's okay that this is how the Indian culture is being portrayed, and I was really, really disappointed about that. And Rishi just kept getting harassed by Dimple all the time, and it almost felt like he didn't care. And Oh my God, this book was just not for me in so many different ways. Now, there's this particular scene where Dimple tells Rishi that she comes to this Insomniacon, which is like a comic con for web developers, and it's important to her because her parents are really conservative and they just want to get her married off. So this is like a super important part of her life where she's trying to prove herself. And she gives this like huge elaborate speech about how she didn't want to feel like objectified and cornered and things like that. And I expected Rishi to like actually empathize and feel for what she was just talking about. But somehow Rishi just laughed or something and made the whole situation about him. Oh, like seriously, how much of a jerk can you be? And then I expected Dimple to respond back by realizing that he was being a jerk. Instead, her insecure mind says, oh, he's being so sweet and nice. Oh, I just couldn't. Now, I haven't DNF'd a book in a really long time. This was one of the books that I actually was this close to DNFing, but I forced myself to complete it just to see what happens and just to see if this book gets better for me, but I'm sorry, it doesn't. And this is one book that I would definitely not recommend. I know there's a lot of people who actually like this book, but I personally wouldn't recommend it. If you do want to read Sandhya Menon's books, then I would definitely recommend There's Something About Sweetie, which is actually like a spin-off of this book, and it focuses more on Rishi's younger brother Ashish, and that book was really a lot of fun. I actually like Sweetie and Ashish so much better than these two. There's also From Twinkle with Love, which is completely different from this series, but that is also a brilliant book that you can consider reading. Thank you for watching this rant video of mine. If you did enjoy it and you consider my opinion, then don't forget to subscribe. Bye!